as we get settled and take those nice deep breaths to settle the nervous system, make sure that we're seated comfortably and upright, nice and solid, well supported. We begin with our first bell. Dog next door has decided to join with us. That too is part of the soundscape, part of being here. So much suffering comes from fighting against what is. As if we could change reality. We could be resentful for the dog barking in the distance, but it's not going to make the dog stop barking. So if we just accept the experience and welcome everything that comes to us, and we don't have to generate the suffering of resenting it or being upset or disturbed. If we're being honest, there's a lot more noise going on inside our own head than there is from the dog or any other noise. We generate our own chatter because a mind's going to do what a mind's going to do. We just don't need to focus on that. We can pay attention to simply whatever is around us and what our bodies are feeling. Now that our breathing has had a chance to settle into a relaxed, easy rhythm, it might be helpful to just do a body scan. Starting at the top of the head, check for any tension we might be holding in our scalp or forehead, around the eyes. Breathing into any tension, any tightness. Ears, cheeks, jaw. Any tightness or constriction in the neck. It helps just gently moving a little bit, weaving back and forth. Feel where you're in balance. body's most relaxed. We often walk around with our shoulders hunched up, hiding our head like a turtle. The shoulders can relax, drop down. Tension in the upper arms or lower arms or in the hands or fingers. Just breathe into this spot. Breathe out the tension. Any restriction in the breathing in the chest? Make sure the breathing is nice and to the bottom of the lungs, not breathing off the top part. Do that so much when we're tense or anticipating things. Breathing from the diaphragm, your belly rising at each breath, is so much more relaxing to the system. Back muscles react to everything. Scan down from the neck, down along the back, for anything that's holding. Fear is often held in the belly, or other emotions. The deep breathing helps with that. For any tension or tightness or restriction in the pelvic area, breathe in right down deep. Down to the upper legs. Sometimes it's helpful to tense those large leg muscles and then relax them. Let them know that they're off duty now. Nothing to run from. And finally, the calves and lower legs into the feet. Gently wiggling the toes to make sure that they're relaxed and able to let go. Draining any residual tension through the feet into the floor. Our beautiful earth can accept it and turn it into love. This truly is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. But there may be other emotions that come up as we wait. There may be emotions that are distressing or disturbing or upsetting. It's not helpful to ignore them or push them down and try to push them away. They are part of being alive. If we won't accept the distressing or disturbing emotions, then we will not fully feel the joyful and loving emotions either. So, whatever comes, greet it with an open heart. Grief must be felt. Sorrow needs to be experienced and recognized. Disappointment may arise, but it just needs to be seen, acknowledged, accepted. Then we can move on to something else. Whatever arises, welcome it with an open heart. Yes, I see you. Thank you for showing up. You're welcome here. It's all a part of being human. when everything is accepted just as it is, when everything is welcomed just as it is, we learn to welcome and accept ourselves just as we are, the way God accepts and welcomes us just as we are. And we come to a sense of peace with things as they are. Thank you.